There's a lot of testing that can be done for infertile couples, and most of this testing is not really very useful and actually can wind up draining your expenses. Unfortunately, insurance does not pay in most cases for infertility treatment or even testing. And so a lot of these tests that are worthless can really drain the finances that you may very well need if you don't have insurance coverage for the treatment that's really going to work. Immune therapy to try to prevent you from having an immune reaction to your child was an interesting thought, but it hasn't panned out and it's turned out to be worthless. The American Society of Reproductive Medicine, ASRM, which is the major professional body that polices and disciplines with SART, infertility physicians, has come out with a report, and this would have been in 1999 even, completely discrediting, with all the scientific studies that were available, the notion that antiphospholipid antibodies affects IVF success rates, or that treatment with aspirin or heparin or steroids or any anti-immune agents, which can be expensive and dangerous, or IVIG is the worst, that any of these expensive treatments have any improving effect on pregnancy rates with IVF. It's been very clearly disproven, and yet people can get distracted with these types of treatments in the hope that they can get pregnant in a simple way, even though it's not so simple, and thereby time is wasted while they're not getting the proper treatment.